And we have a Risar, also known as a giant, and a mammoth. Let's just give them a wide berth. I don't think that encounter would go well if they decided I might be a threat. I'm not entirely sure what would make a giant decide that I am a threat, but who knows? I'm not going to test it either way. I don't know what this place is, but it's quite peaceful. Huh. Maybe this would make a good camping spot. I might do that on the way back, but for now, I have business to take care of. Hopefully I'm heading in roughly the right direction. It's, oh, that was dumb. Never look directly at the sun. Although, I'm surprised my old eyes can still take it. The sun. It's actually more difficult than I anticipated to tell direction without being able to see Red Mountain. Well, there's a little town up here. That might be a good place to stop. Maybe not for the evening, but it'll be good to at least know that it's here. One thing that you learn quickly on Solstheim is that if there is a deer running in your direction, something else spooked it. And in that kind of an instance, you need to be cautious. Because chances are, it's something that wants to eat you. Or at least the thing that it's chasing. Okay. Back on the road. It's quite nice out here. I don't think I have much to worry about from these people. That's what I mean to say. So they're farming out here. I wonder who they are. And children.
You're gonna get it, Sissel! Why? What did I do? I told you to weed the garden by sunset, and you didn't do it. Now you're in big trouble.
I wonder how Mordgood's doing.
I'd be a lot warmer and a lot happier with a belly full of mead.
Oh aye, me too. I'm sure they're fine. Morrowind is a harsh place, but if I do say so myself, my daughter comes from good stock. I assume. I wonder what's up here. This is the way I have to go. So I assume Mordgood comes from. Hello! Come on! Pesky little things. Well, there's a place I'm not going to go into. That many skeevers seems like a bad omen to me. Okay. That's where we're going, that direction. So, you know, being out here. Oh, this is going to be fun. Alright. Let's try not to break anything. That could be tragic. There. Being out here. In the tundra. It kind of makes me feel young again. Well, it would if my joints weren't complaining at me. But that's alright. That is something I'm used to at this point. You put up with it for so many years and it just ceases to matter, really. We're going up into those mountains up there. Okay. All right. I was on you. I might as well take care of this one. This does seem like rather a harsh place, but there are wolves farther up the road. And I'm going to get out of here before they smell the blood. I'm going to guess that they'd mob that carcass. Alright. This looks like a very sheer drop. But I think I can make it. We'll see. Alright. I assume if we follow that river. Yes, that should be where we're going. Okay. Never in my life have I missed volcanic rock. Quite as much. Flat platforms, like somebody carved out a bunch of stone stakes and stuck them into the ground. That makes for good climbing. This is a bit more precarious. There we go. My hands may not be as steady as they used to be, but they're still as strong. And so are my legs, it seems. Well, that's unfortunate. Who lost a cart? Have to keep better hold of your carts in this kind of terrain, I think. Alright, this will also be a good place to get some water, I think. It looks like. Whoa! Hello! Oh no, there's another one! Oh no. Oh! Those big, nasty cats! I'm going to feel that in the morning. I've never been so thankful for heavy armor in my life. And it's getting late, which means I'm going to have to set up camp soon. That would be great if I could actually harvest these pelts without making a mess of them. Unfortunately, I'm not much used to working with saber-cats. Okay, now where's a good spot? I'm thinking up in here might be my best bet. Given that it's not on any major roads, and I have a hard time, this might work. Maybe. I don't know if it's flat enough. I don't know if that really matters. But I have a hard time imagining most wildlife getting up here. Maybe a fox or a rabbit or two. Maybe. I think this'll work, actually. Won't be the most elegant setup, but... Has anybody ever known me to be elegant? That fits just about perfectly right in there. Perfect. Okay, now... Don't think... Is there a camp up there? Thought I saw something. Might have just been the fog. Don't think anybody's going to be able to see my fire. They might see the smoke, but... I don't think anybody would want to come... traipsing all the way up here. Now where am I going to put this fire? I'm kind of wary that all of this is dry. I don't really want a chance that it might catch on fire. Oh well. How often have I built fires before? This shouldn't be. Shouldn't be too much of a worry, and I'm out of tinder. That's all right. Here we go. Maybe. Oh, come on. Maybe I shouldn't have been so worried. There. Come on. There we go. There's a little fire. Let's feed this little thing, shall we? There we go. And I can just run up here to get more wood. Oh. Come on. Get my boots stuck on the rocks. Okay. I don't need much, just a few branches. I've got time. I've got light. That should do it. Replenish some of the stock that I just used. It's never good to be caught out in the middle of nowhere with no firewood. and no way to get it. My father once told me a story of him and a friend of his. They went camping out on a glacier. And that didn't work out so well. No firewood. Okay. Let's get some water and some dinner and go to sleep. It's been a long day and it's going to be a longer day tomorrow. Alright. Good night, fire.